shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus, thank you for a great and wonderful time to be a blessing to your people. I pray for everyone watching this program that they will be blessed. Bless their homes, O God. Make this word to be very clear unto them. Father, in the name of Jesus, this is the first episode of this great teachings that will reach multitudes of people. I ask in the name of Jesus that the ministering spirit will go forth and spread this news and spread this program so that your will and your purpose will come to pass. Thank you, Father, for you went with them confirming the word with signs following. And as this word will be going forth, you will be confirming it in the lives and in the heart of every single one that receives and believes. Thank you for you will do so. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. I welcome you today to this particular program, Bible Concepts with the Darling Pastor. I am the Darling Pastor, Reverend Gbade Ogunlana. By the grace of God, we're going to take time to look at various subjects from the Bible. By the grace of God and His help, I will be taking us through different subjects from the Bible with all clarity and simplicity. And if you have any question or the other, I will create a link how you can get in touch with me. Once again, you're welcome. I'm Reverend Gbade Ogunlana, but you can simply call me the Darling Pastor. I'm starting with the subject of faith. I want us to look at the Bible concepts of faith. What does the word faith signifies or means in the Word of God? I'm taking my text from the book of Hebrews chapter 11, starting from verse 1. The Bible says, "Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen." Faith is the substance of things hoped for. Darling Pastor, why are you studying the subject of faith? This is why. I want to bring to us the importance of this subject today, so that you will understand why we are starting with this. I remember in the university days, there were a lot of preachers that come to our university to share God's word with us. I know there are some classes of pastors and Bible teachers that come around, and you know, some of them will talk about the dressing of Aaron, the priest, the garment of Aaron. Then after the teachings, you ask yourself, what does that have to do with putting sugar in my tea? No, that doesn't add anything to me. There are various subjects you can teach from the Bible, but one of the foremost subjects that you and me need to understand very clearly is the subject of faith. That is why I'm starting with the concept of faith. I want you to have a clear understanding of this subject. Number one, why is faith important? The first major reasons why the subject of faith is important is because it is the only way to please God. You need to understand something about God. God is a God of faith. There are some certain things that if you do them, God will be satisfied with you. What does it mean to please? It means to satisfy. It means that you do something for someone and is not asking for more. Have you ever gotten to a restaurant before to eat and you ate until you are satisfied? You know, when you are satisfied, nothing else will appeal to you. God is a God of faith. There are some certain things that you do that may not hand hay in the presence of God, but when you exercise faith, God approves it, because by nature He is a God of faith. So that is why Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6 says, "But without faith it is impossible to please Him." The Bible says without faith you cannot please God. There are a lot of people all over the world. They are doing their best in living right. And you must live right. God wants us to live in accordance with His laws, as revealed to us in His Word. So God wants us to live right. But you can live right, you can live well, and not please God. Why? Because Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6 says, "But without faith, it is impossible to please God." Look at an interesting thing about the next statement. He says that for he that cometh to God must believe that he is. The Bible says that if you want to come to God, you must believe that God is. There are a lot of people on the earth today that still keep wondering whether there is a God. There is a God. You've seen a lot of people that says, "I don't understand and I don't believe that there is a God. If there is a God, he should prove to me that he exists." You will realize that many of such people, God never proves himself that he's alive to them. You know why? This is why. This verse says, "For without faith it is impossible to please God. For he that comes to God must believe that he is." If you're an atheist and you happen to be watching this program, let me tell you how God will show that he is to you. You see, your attitude has been like, "If you're God, show yourself to me." That is not how he operates. You know what he wants you to do? He said you first believe that he is, then he will manifest himself to you. As you're watching me, if you just believe, if you just make the inward adjustment, that I believe that God is, you will see that he will manifest himself to you. Why? Because he said, "He that comes to God," that means that you have not been with God, "he that comes to God must believe." Very interesting. He says that must believe. It's not a matter of choice. He's not giving you choices. It's a must. You must believe that he is. Why? Because he is a God of faith. That is the way he operates. God is a God of faith. And when you exercise faith, you will please him. Faith pleases God. Faith pleases God. When you take the step of faith, God will be satisfied. That is why I am teaching this subject, so that you have a grasp of how to please God. Thousands and millions of people on the earth are living, and they are living well. Character-wise, they are doing their best. But that is not what wins God's approval. What wins God's approval is that you must believe God. What wins God's approval is that you must believe God, because he is a God of faith. I remember many years ago, I was pastoring in a village in one of the states in Nigeria. And pastoring the village with little development, I enjoyed the pastoring, because the villagers really love me, and I love my job. I love God, and I love them. And working there as a pastor, it was a wonderful time. Then at a particular point, I started sensing that it is time to leave that place. "Darling pastor, what do you mean by that?" See, the working as a pastor under God is a little different from working in a corporation. But sometimes you have some things that are very similar. For example, when you're working in a corporation, your company may decide to transfer you from a place to another. God does that also. I was working in the village as a pastor. Then he wanted me to leave that place and go to another town to work for him. Now, when I started sensing that, "Pastor, what do you mean by sensing that?" Let me tell you sometimes how to know when your time is up in a place. When you are working in a place, I'm talking now more like if you are working for God. When you are working in a place, maybe as a pastor or something, you enjoy your job. The people you are working over, they enjoy your presence. A time comes when it is God's will for you to change. There may be some issues that will be coming up between you and the people you are serving. Remember, you enjoy working with them, they enjoy working with you, but sometimes when your time is up there, the things that you do normally and you derive joy, you will no longer be happy. You find out that the things that bring smiles on your face, they are no longer doing that. It might be a pointer that your time was up. I enjoy visiting these people. I even visit them where they are doing their farming, because 90% of them are farmers. I visit them on their farmland. I discuss with them, and we had a wonderful time. Then I started not to enjoy that again. So I've got to start praying and say, God, are you telling me that my time is up here? Am I supposed to leave this place? Now, I remember something very interesting happened. And I want to show you how faith, how God is a God of faith. It pleases God when we exercise faith. One day, I had to tell my boss then. I told him that, I went to him and tell him that my time seems to be up here. I believe it is time that I move on. And he was like, Pastor, I know you are a real person. I know you are a good person. And this is, by the way, let me tell you, anywhere and whoever you work with, be a good person. Those characters have their home place. If you live very well, people are prone to believe you. Be very transparent. Be a nice person. Don't leave your boss suddenly. Life is not like that. There are some things that are more important than money. And that one of the things is people. People are very important. And that is why don't always break relationship in an awkward manner. You might need those people later on. So I went to my boss and discussed with him that I sensed that my time was up. He said, Pastor Gbade, where are you going to after? I said, sincerely, I don't know. I only knew in my heart that my time was up here. He said, Be, well, I would love to know where you go to. I said, give me 2-3 weeks, I'll pray. I'm sure I will know where to go to. And I took time to pray. Another time, I'm going to teach us how to be led by the Spirit of God. I will show us how I did pray in those days. Because there is a way to know how to pray. I will show us everything later on. When we are looking at the way God leads his own people, how to be led by the Spirit of God. Now, I went to pray, and when I prayed about it, to get direction from God, I was praying in an unknown tongue, praying in the Spirit, to be sensitive in my heart, to pick the leadings of God. Now, after a time, I was to travel that day, and I carried my bags, and trying to see how to travel. But when I looked at my watch, I found out that it was already late. So I went back to the room. Now, as I went back to the room like that, I put down my loads and rested on the bed. Immediately, I lie down on the bed like this. I just heard a voice that said, so place is the next place where you are going to pastor, and this is the name of the pastor of that church. Now, I want you to see something. It was a supernatural leading. God gave me the address of the next place to go to and the name of the pastor there. It was spectacular. You know, such leadings can be very wonderful. But I want you to see what led to that. The first time when I said I knew my time was up there, I knew that one in my spirit. I exercised faith. See, it's not that I saw a vision, nor did I dream any dream, nor did I receive any prophecy. I just knew in my heart, and I acted in faith. But once I acted in faith, God thrilled me with a supernatural leading. He just spoke to me, almost in an audible voice. I'm going to talk about audible voice when we get to that subject also. And it's because I took this step of faith, He now supernaturally showed me in a spectacular way. He spoke to me, he said, so is the name of the church where you are pastoring. This is the name of the town where that church is. This is the name of the pastor of that church. It was a spectacular leading. But it's because I took the step of faith that supernaturally he did that. Let me show you another thing. Pastor, what are you establishing? I'm establishing the fact that when you exercise faith, God honors it. Like that, Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6 says that without faith, it is impossible to please Him. When you walk in faith, you will please God. You know, at a particular time in life also, I was led to go and start a church in another town entirely. I've always been going from one place by the grace of God to start church in another place. And how did I know? I just knew in my heart that I was supposed to go and start a church there. It wasn't naturally convenient, but because I knew in my heart, I decided to take the step. I announced to them, the people that are working with me, I said, I believe God is leading us to go and start a church in another place. Now, this other place, this other state, is more expensive than where we were. And we didn't even have the money to go and do it. I only know that the time to go is up. I should go there. So I announced to them, I said, we are starting church in this place. And somebody said, Pastor, where are we going to get the money? Do we have the money? I said, naturally, we don't have the money. But the only thing I have now is the conviction that we should go there. And like Abraham, we took step of faith. You know what happened? About 7 days after, there is a parcel of land that we have been thinking, planning to sell for over 2 years without getting anybody to buy it. Do you know that just within a week after, somebody just bought the land? It was the money of the land that we now use to go and start the church in another state. See, we took the step of faith and God honors it. Why? Because faith pleases God. When you take step of faith, God will be happy. It honors God. It pleases God. That is why we are starting with this subject. I want you to live a life that will be well pleasing to God. Darling Pastor, is that the only reason why we are starting with this subject? No. Let me show you another thing about faith. Why we are studying this subject of faith. You know, in the natural, if I want to give you this iPad, what do? You will stretch forth your hand to collect or receive it from me. So we can say, it is with the hands that man receives things in the natural. How do we receive things from God? By faith. It is by faith that we receive from heaven. That is why this subject is important. That is why I'm telling you, wherever you are, follow consistently every week this teaching, and I can guarantee you something. I will teach you how to receive help from God. Many times we think that receiving help from God is very far. It's not far. Sometimes we think it's difficult. It's very simple. You only need to understand how. Why? Because it is by faith that we receive from heaven. That is why this subject is very important. It's more important than you to know how big the beard of Aaron is. It's more important than you to know the middle tabernacle, inner tabernacle. It's more important than that. Why? Because if you want to receive from heaven, you need to understand very well the subject of faith. Where is that in the Bible, darling Pastor? Mark chapter 11. Let me show you Mark chapter 11. See what the scripture says in verse 24. Mark chapter 11, verse 24. You see in the book of Mark chapter 11, verse 24, the Bible stated that whatsoever you desired, when you pray, believe that you receive them and you will have them. Whatsoever you desire, when you pray, believe that you receive them and you shall have them. Therefore, I say unto you, whatsoever you desire when you pray, believe that you receive them, believe that you receive them, and you shall have them. Oh, how I wish we have much time to explain this. See, the Bible says, therefore, I say unto you, whatsoever you desire when you pray. Take note of the word you in that verse. Whatsoever, therefore, I say unto you, whatsoever you desire when you pray, believe that you receive and you shall have. So you will see that this verse is about you. You are the one that will do the desiring. You are the one that you will do the praying. You are the one that will do the believing. The Bible says, and you shall receive. You are the one that will do the receiving. Now let me show you something here. It says, whatsoever you desire when you pray, believe that you receive them and you shall have them. Many times we think that we will receive according to the least of our desires. Do you know that is not what this verse says? Look at it again. It says, whatsoever you desire, when you pray, believe that you receive them, and you shall have them. What them will you receive? It is the them that you believe. Believe that you receive them, and you shall have them. Believe that you receive them, and you shall have them. Believe that you receive them, and you shall have them. No, it's not the least of the desire that God responds to. It is which out of the desires that you believe that you receive, that you will have. That is, believing is receiving. It is by faith that we receive. Faith is the hand with which we collect from heaven. That's why this subject is very important. If you have a clear understanding of this subject, you will be able to receive more help from God. Listen to this. Have you been praying without receiving answer? Thank God we are here. By the grace of God, I will teach you how to pray and receive. Oh, darling pastor, I wish I have a prophet. No. Just listen very well. Pastor, I am not a reverend. You don't have to be. The Bible says that believe that you receive them. Faith is like the hand with which we receive from heaven. Some of us think it is by crying. It's not by crying. Some people think it is by fasting. It is not by fasting. Many a time, many of us have stretched forth our elbow, wanting to receive from heaven. But you don't collect with the elbow. You need to stretch the hand in order to receive. What is that hand? Faith is that hand. That is why the clearer the subject of faith to you, the more you are able to receive. The Bible says, whatsoever you desire when you pray, believe that you receive them and you shall have them. What have I taught today? I've taught us that we are starting with the concept of faith. I want you to have a clear understanding of the subject of faith. And why is that, darling pastor? Number one, so that you will live a life that pleases God. You can have good character, and you should have, and still not please God. There is something about believing God that gladdens the heart of God. There is something about believing God that makes God to rejoice. There is something about believing God that honors God. So, when you understand this subject of faith very well, you will be living a life that brings honor to God. Secondly, faith is the hand with which we receive from heaven. You can have more things added unto you. You can receive from heaven more when you have the understanding of the subject of faith. By the grace of God, as you continue every week to listen to these teachings, you will have a deeper understanding of the Word of God, and together we'll be able to share testimonies together. You can tell your neighbors, you can tell people around that there is a subject on this station at this hour every week. It is Bible Concepts with the Darling Pastor. And I'm that Darling Pastor. I'm Reverend Gbade Ogunlana. You can get in touch with me anytime. Have a very lovely and blessed week.